PC water cooling has been a pastime of mine for the last decade or so. So you might wonder then why it is that we hardly ever cover it on the channel anymore. And the truth is that low-cost AIO liquid coolers are more or less the same, to within a degree or two, and as for custom water cooling, well, it's expensive, making it niche, and quite frankly, there's not a lot of improvement left to make. So again, we're talking a degree or two if you're lucky. It's mostly compatibility updates on both sides. But that is where everything changes today. EK's new line of custom water cooling parts promises the low cost of AIOs with the future upgradability, not to mention nearly all the performance of custom water cooling. But can it hold up to all these claims? Let's find out. LTX, the first meetup we've done in over 2 years! Go check it out! Only, like, 800 tickets remaining! I've said for a while that water cooling is more about fashion than practicality these days, and the funny thing about fashion is that it's, cyclical. And EK's fluid gaming kits are no exception here. Their revolutionary feature, the fact that they're made exclusively out of aluminum, was first popularized by Coolant over 10 years ago. Now, the advantages of aluminum are several. It's incredibly light, it's fast and easy to machine, and, perhaps most importantly, it's much less expensive than copper. So why did Coolant eventually abandon aluminum for copper? Great question, and we'll get into that a bit later. First, let's take a look at the three kits that EK is selling today. Each one of them includes an all-new aluminum CPU block called the Supremacy AX, a PWM-controlled pump with an integrated tube reservoir, already a big advantage over basic all-in-ones that don't include an easy way to top them up, some basic tubing, EK's well-regarded Vardar fans, and EK's new aluminum compression fittings that they designed specifically for these kits. Where the kits differ from each other is in the radiator configurations and the inclusion or absence of a universal Pascal GPU block. But again, we'll touch a bit more on that later. Assembly was easier than you'd probably think. Yeah, it's more time-consuming than installing an AIO, but it also shouldn't take longer than about an hour for the non-GPU kits, plus 30 to 45 minutes for each video card you add. And during the process, we found both things we appreciated. Compression fittings are so much nicer than janky integrated barbs that make the components hard to reuse, and things that we didn't. This tubing was a definite cost-saving measure, which, aside from acquiring us to lube it up with warm water and push a little harder than we'd like, also required us to carefully plan our loop to avoid any excess kinkiness. On the subject of planning, if you spring for the A240G, be sure to check the fine print. Its block is universal as long as you're running a GTX 1060 or up, and you also happen to have a Founders Edition version of your card. So AMD users and last generation NVIDIA users need not apply. But we can live with all the compromises if fluid gaming lives up to EK's promises. So for our test, we used EK's new kits, popular AIOs from Corsair, and custom copper components from EK's own lineup on one of our ASUS X99 test benches with a Core i7-5960X and NVIDIA's Titan XP. Then, to eliminate variables to the greatest degree possible, we used EK's Vardar fans running at max speed and 1000 RPM, a setting that we determined to be a good balance between performance and noise in the Fractal Design Define R5. And the results are mostly as expected. which is a good thing. With the A120 and the copper 120 setup trading blows, while the H60 lags slightly behind. Moving on, the A240 looks like a much more compelling value than its little brother. For a very small price bump, you get a radiator that's twice the size and another fan, which considering its retail value of 18 bucks, means based on these performance numbers, you're getting a lot more bang for your buck. Last up to the plate is the A240G. It's kind of like the rich uncle of the A240. Like, he's actually not much better cooling-wise, but at least he has a boat. And by boat, I mean a GPU block. Here, we got a little creative with our comparative testing, putting it up against a similar copper loop and a dual AIO setup with NZXT's Kraken G12. Obviously, that one isn't an ideal setup aesthetically, but it was the previous value full system water cooling king. And you can clearly see that that is no longer the case. So then, EK's claims of better upgradability and better performance compared to AIOs seem to check out. So what's the drawback? Well, that brings us to why Coolant discontinued their aluminum products. If you mix these with copper products in the same loop, it's possible, nay, likely, that you will experience what's known in the biz as a really bad time, or galvanic corrosion. It can be so bad, and I don't personally trust any anti-corrosive additive that claims that it prevents it, that your block can be eaten away to the point where it can actually spring a leak. So, EK is taking a big risk here. A risk that some user will combine their value aluminum lineup with their premium copper lineup and possibly get gunk in their blocks or at worst, bork his or her system. But seeing the performance and the price, I don't blame them for trying, and I have to give them credit for tackling this as safely as I think they could. They're launching these parts exclusively in kits for now, rather than individually, and there are warning labels everywhere. So bottom line then, if you want to invest in custom water cooling that you can reuse and upgrade down the line, but you want to save a few bucks, we really like this product as a whole, especially the A240 and the A240G. FreshBooks helps small business owners and freelancers get more organized, more productive, and I mean, cash flow is everything when you're running a small business. Get paid more quickly. You can create and send professional-looking invoices in seconds. You can set up online payments with just a couple clicks to get paid up to 4 days faster. You can see when a client has seen your invoice, putting an end to the guessing games. And perhaps most importantly, it's all cloud-based, so you can take the entire functionality of FreshBooks with you on the go, on your mobile device. So there's no excuse anymore for working hard all day and then having to go home at the end of the day and try to remember, what were my expenses? How many hours did I put into that job? No, you can keep track of it as you go. So try out an unrestricted 30-day free trial at freshbooks.com/techtips and enter Linus Tech Tips in the How You Heard About Us section. You're gonna like it. So thanks for watching, guys. If you disliked this video, you can hit that button. But if you liked it, hit the like button, get subscribed, maybe consider checking out where to buy the products we featured at the link in the video description. Also down there, we've got a link to our merch store, which has cool shirts like this one, and our community forum, which you should totally join.